गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन टुडेज क्लास विल सी द नेक्स्ट थ्योरम, दैट इज गॉस डाइवर्जेंस थ्योरम, और आल्सो वी कॉल इट इज ओनली अ डाइवर्जेंस थ्योरम आल्सो. सो गॉस डाइवर्जेंस थ्योरम और वी कैन से ओनली डाइवर्जेंस थ्योरम. सो व्हाट इज द स्टेटमेंट विल सी नाउ. स्टेटमेंट ऑफ गॉस डाइवर्जेंस थ्योरम, इफ वी वी स्टैंड्स फॉर वॉल्यूम, is V is the volume bounded by a surface S and vector F, is a continuously differentiable vector function, then triple integration over the volume V, divergence of vector F into dV is equal to double integral of over the surface S vector f dot n cap ds. So this is a statement. So because it is a divergence theorem, always we have three dimension, so that's why volume is going to be considered in terms of three dimension. So therefore triple integration is nothing but divergence of vector f of dv, which is nothing but what here, double integration over the surface s f dot n cap ds, and you know that n cap ds is nothing but what, it is dy dx of dy dz of I dx dz of j plus dx dy of k. So where n cap is positive unit vector outwards drawn normal to s. S stand for surface here. So this, with the help of this statement, we'll see the problems based on Gauss divergence theorem, or I can say that only a divergence theorem. The question is, if vector f is equal to 2x square minus 3z of I minus 2xy of j minus 4x of k, evaluate triple integration over the vector over the volume V del dot vector f dv, where V is the region bounded by the planes x is equal to 0, y is equal to 0, z is equal to 0, and 2x plus 2y plus z equal to 4. So this is the question, how they will ask for the divergence here. So here the procedure is same. Given vector f, we need to collect, that is 2x square minus 3z of I minus 2xy of j minus 4x of k. And as we know that, so divergence theorem is given by triple integration over the volume V, divergence of vector f of dv is equal to double integration over the surface S vector f dot n cap ds. So now divergence of vector f, which is nothing but del dot vector f, means we need to we know what is this, we'll calculate first. So divergence of vector f I have taken, which is nothing but dou f by dou x plus dou f by dou y plus dou f by dou z. So what is f? So this is our complete f. So we'll see here, because del dot vector f, if you make it, you will get only what here, functions of coefficient, means here function f you have to write in a such a way that it should be a coefficient of I only. Here what here we have to write only the coefficient of j only, and here we have to write coefficient of k only. So I have written here, just see. So it is dou by dou x of it is 2x square minus 3z plus coefficient of j is what here, minus 2xy, then coefficient of k is what here, minus 4x I have taken. So we should not mention this, so just I have shown you this is so we'll not mention this here, we'll write out here dot vector f. Now so differentiation of 2x square minus 3z with respect to x is 4x, because 2x square will become 4x, 3z will become 0, leave it. So plus into minus is minus. Partial derivative of 2xy with respect to y is 2x. So plus into minus is minus. So partial derivative of minus 4x with respect to z is 0, because no z term, other will become constant. So derivative of constant is 0. So therefore del cross vector f is equal to 2x. So we got the left hand side here, where here z varies from 0 to, so you just see here. So here we'll start with backwards, z will see, then y, then x. So this is a line they have given. So when z is 0, here you put z is equal to 0, so what happens, it will become 4, means, or else I can say z is equal to, what happens here, 4 minus 2x. If you shift this 2x and 2y to the right hand side, it will become 4 minus 2x minus 2y. So what happens here, when z is 0, it will varies from 0 to 4 minus 2 minus 2x minus 2y, because we are taking z is equal to what here, 4 minus 2x minus 2y, means when z is 0, as per this condition, when z is 0, so what happens here, z is 0 means it will become varies from z, varies from 0 to 4 minus 2x minus 2y. Similarly, we'll go back. When z is 0, y is 0, what happens, we'll see now. Okay, so when z is 0, we get what here, 2x plus 2y equal to 4, which is nothing but what here, x plus y equal to 2, because divide both sides 2. So from this, what we'll get here, so I will keep y outside, so it will become 2 minus x. So y varies from what here, 0 to 2 minus x. So this is a condition you should remember, and previously already we have taken. So this also we should be remember here, z from 0 to 4 minus 2x minus 2y. And when z is 0, here directly we need to apply, so what left here means z, you need to apply 0 here, what left, 2x minus 2y equal to 4. So 2x minus 2y equal to 4, which is nothing but divide by 2, it become x plus y is equal to 2. So here if y is 0, so it will come out here, 2 minus x, so varies from 0 to 2 minus x. Similarly, when z is 0, y is 0, we'll get, means you put z is equal to 0, y is equal to 0 in this expression. Z is 0, y is 0 means 2x is equal to 4, 2x is equal to 4, which is nothing but what here, x is equal to 2. So when x is 0, it varies from 0 to 2. X is 0, what left here, 2, so x varies from 0 to 2. So these are the limits to simplify, because we have triple integration. So therefore, triple integration over the volume V, del dot vector f dot dv, is nothing but integration, x varies from what here, 0 to 2, y varies from 0 to 2 minus x, z varies from 0 to 4 minus 2x minus 2y. And what we got, del dot vector f, del dot vector f, we got how much here, 2x. And because of dv is nothing but what here, 3 dimension, it is dz, dy and dx. So on integration, firstly we'll integrate with respect to z. So integration of z with respect to 2x, integration of 2x with respect to z, it will become 2z into z, and the limit varies from 0 to 4 minus 2x minus y, and this dy and dx as it is. So apply, keep 2x as it is, apply upper limit for this z. So if you apply upper limit, 4 minus 2x minus 2y, lower limit is 0, leave it. So dy, dx. So you 2 you will take outside. So once this 2 out, left what here, x, x into 4 is 4x, minus x into 2x is 2x square, then minus x into 2y will become 2xy into dy into dx. Now this function will integrate with respect to y now. So this 2 as it is, integration 0 to 2 for x, keep as it is. Integration of 4x with respect to y is 4xy, minus as it is. Integration of 2x square, 2 as it is. Integration of 2x square with respect to y is 2x square as it is, constant. Integration of constant is y with respect to y, minus as it is. Next, integration of 2xy with respect to y. So 2 and x we need to keep as it is. Integration of y is y square by 2. 2 and 2 get cancelled. That's why I have not shown here. Okay. So once we got this, so this will be applied again upper and lower limit. Wherever y is there, you replace. This y will be replaced by 2 minus x. This y will be replaced by 2 minus x. And this y will be replaced by 2 minus x. This will become 2 minus x whole square into dx as it is now. So therefore, 2 is outside, integration from 0 to 2. So I have replaced the value of y, and y square is there. So 2 minus x whole square. Open the bracket. 4x into 2 is 8x. Plus into minus is minus. 4x into x is 4x square. Minus as it is. 2x square into 2 is 4x square. Minus minus plus. 2x square into x is 2x cube. Then minus x as it is. You apply first a minus b whole square formula. So a square, that is 2 square is 4 plus b square is x square minus 2ab, it will become 4x into dx. First simplify before integrating. 8x, so 4x minus 4x square minus 4x square is minus 8x square, the plus 2x cube as it is. Open the bracket. Minus x into 4 is minus 4x, minus into plus is minus, x into x cube is x square is x cube, minus minus plus, x into 4x is what here, 4x square. So again you just see any like term is there, add or subtract. So 2x cube, highest power, 2x cube minus x cube will become x cube. Next, minus 8x square plus 4x square will become minus 4x square plus 8x minus 4x will become plus 4x. Now this is ready for integration with respect to x. So integration of x cube is x raised to 4 upon 4 minus 4 as it is. Integration of x square is x cube upon 3 plus 4 as it is. Integration of x is x square upon 2. So simplify. So here 2 and 4 cancels and it will left with 2x. Apply upper limit. X raised to 2 means x raised to 4. 2 raised to 4 will become 16 upon 4, this 2 as it is, minus, and 4 upon 3 I have kept as it is. 2 cube, because upper limit is 2 cube, if you apply it will become 8, plus this 2 as it is. 2 square is 4, lower limit is 0, so if you apply 0 upon 4, 0 upon anything, this will become 0, leave it. So on simplification, so 16 upon 4 is 4, minus, no, nothing is going to be cancelled. 4 8s are 32 upon 3 plus 4 2s are 8. So on simplification, we'll get 8 by 3. So therefore, del cross, therefore, triple integration over the volume V, del cross, del dot vector F into dV is nothing but 8 upon 3. So in this way, we need to simplify the examples of Gauss divergence theorem, or I can say that a divergence theorem. Next example is, using divergence theorem, evaluate double integration over the surface FS, F dot n cap ds, where F is 2xy I plus yz square of j plus xz of k, and S is the total surface of the rectangle parallel pipad bounded by the planes x is equal to 0, y is equal to 0, z is equal to 0, x is equal to 1, y is equal to 2, z is equal to 3. See, this is what here, a statement of our left hand side, means left hand side of what here, or right hand side of divergence, means either they will give in the form of this way, triple integration of divergence of f into dv, or they will give one more form, double integration over the surface S, f dot, vector f dot n cap ds, any one. So, but they will mention whether it is a divergence theorem or what. Now, solution. By using divergence theorem, we have statement, double integration over the surface S, vector f dot n cap ds is equal to triple integration over the volume V, divergence of vector v into dv. So we know that. So first we'll find what is divergence of f. So divergence of f is nothing but what here? It is del dot vector f. So we'll partially derivate x with respect to coefficient of our vector f is what here. So I will mention here. So here vector f is nothing but 2xy of I plus yz square of j plus xz of k. So this is our vector f. So coefficient of I you multiply for the function of x. Coefficient of j will become what here? Function of dou by dou y, and coefficient of k will be function of dou by dou z. So therefore dou by dou x of 2xy is 2y, dou by dou y of yz square will become z square, and dou by dou z of xz will become x. So this is divergence of vector f. Now left hand side, that is left hand side of our divergence theorem. Double integration vector f dot n cap ds is nothing but triple integration. So triple integration, we know what is a del cross, means we are going to find, as per the question, we need to evaluate the value of this. So therefore we have kept this left hand side as it is. So here we'll execute the values. So triple integration, so here already they have given x varies from 0 to what here? 1. Then y varies from 0 to 2, and z varies from what here? 0 to 3. So we'll write directly, no need of diagram. X varies from 0 to 1, y varies from 0 to 2, z varies from 0 to 3. Divergence of vector f, we got 2y plus z square plus x, we'll take it. And dv is nothing but, it is dz dy dx, or dx dy dz, anything. So firstly we are going to integrate with respect to z, so we'll write dz dy dx. So first we'll integrate with respect to z, then we'll integrate with respect to y, then we'll integrate with respect to x now. So we'll see that concept one by one. Now, integration 0 to 1, 0 to 2. It is with respect to x, with respect to y. So integration of 2 integration of 2y. So integration of 2y with respect to z is how much here? It is 2y into z. Integration of z square will become z cube by 3, plus integration of x with respect to z is x into z, limit from 0 to 3. So apply upper limit as z is equal to 3 here, lower limit is 0, leave it. So z is 3, means 3 2s are 6 of y, plus z cube, 3 cube is 27 upon 3, plus z is 3, means it will become 3x. So we have applied upper limit, lower limit is 0, you leave it. Now this is ready for, or else you rearrange 6y. So 27 upon 3 is 9 plus 3x. Now it is ready for the integration with respect, we can integrate with respect to y. So integration of 6y with respect to y is 6 as it is, y integration of y is y square by 2, plus 9 is a constant. So integration of 9 with respect to dy is 9y, plus 3 as it is, x as it is, because both are constant with respect to y. So integration of 3x with respect to y will become y. So limit from 0 to 2. So replace upper limit as y is equal to 2, lower limit as y is equal to 0. So 2 1s are 2 3s are 3 times. So 2 square will become 4, plus 9 into 2, plus 3 into y value is 2. Lower limit is 0 here. If you apply, it becomes 0. Leave it. So therefore, 3 4s are 12, plus 9 2s are 18, plus 6x into dx. So 12 plus 18 is 30, plus 6x. So on integration, integration of 30 with respect to x is 30x, plus 6 as it is. Integration of x is x square by 2, limit from 0 to 1. So therefore, apply upper limit, 30 into 1, plus 2 1s are 2 3s are, so 3 into 1 square is 1, so 3 into 1 is 3, so 30 plus 3 is how much here? 33. So like that, so the problems based on divergence of theorems are going to simplify. So you need to remember the statement correctly, and which way they are asking, you need to check out.